I love this. I believe you had Raheem Mostert in the next tier previously. This morning, you moved him all the way up to running back 17 as they faced the Los Angeles Chargers in week one.
So the Chargers faced the Dolphins late last year, and I thought that was Tua's probably worst game, maybe of his career. Where the Chargers are weakest at is defending the run. Now, they're trying to stop the run. This has been something that they talked about for a long time in LA, but the Chargers allowed 5.6 yards per carry last year, the second most rushing yards allowed to running backs. Right now, it's going to be maybe Devon Achane as the RB2, but I think it's more likely to be Salvin Ahmed. I don't think either of them are going to be banked on. I think it's going to be Raheem Mostert as the clear RB1, and I just think that the way that the Dolphins can keep this thing close is a little bit more of a balanced approach on offense, which means Raheem Mostert, I think, in all capacities. They've used him as a pass catcher before. He has gotten goal line usage again. So with this is the best opportunity I think that we'll have for the Dolphins the entire season when we're talking about the running backs.
Brandon Staley's got to step up, man. Like, I understand it's part of his philosophy that, like, hey, we'll let you run the ball. But they have lost games because of that. I mean, this comes from the great Rich Rebar. In 2022, the Chargers allowed a league high, as you said, 5.6 yards per carry to opposing running backs. They were 31st in success rate. They were 31st in yards allowed before contact on those carries and 30th in yards allowed after contact. So if you allow them to run the ball and then after you try to tackle them, allow them to run the ball some more, again, you get Raheem Mostert, who among all running backs last year with 100 or more carries, he was 8th in the NFL in yards per carry and 4th in runs to gain 10 or more yards. I love this aggressive ranking from you with Raheem Mostert as running back 17.
When you watch the Chargers last year, their linebackers, corners, and safeties, except for Derwin James, just couldn't make tackles. And like, if they just need to make those tackles, or otherwise they're going to the house. And that obviously Raheem Mostert fits the bill.
Calvin Ridley, you're going out on a ledge here, and I absolutely love it. Your wide receiver 6, the first time we've seen him in what, 2 seasons against the Indianapolis Colts.
Yeah, so last year the Colts, or this offseason, I should say, the Colts lost 3 of their corners. Right now, they might be starting a second-round rookie in Julius Brents, who I thought was very inconsistent as a prospect, and then 2022 UDFA, a corner on the perimeter. It's as bad as you get for the Colts defense. One of my biggest takeaways doing all the research for this week is how horrific this Colts roster is, and I'm shocked that the Jaguars only projected to win by 5 points. If I was picking just one side of the week, I would just take the Jaguars in every single category. And for Calvin Ridley, he basically dominated the preseason. No hiccups in his training camp. And last year, even without him, the Jaguars were 4th in wide receiver fantasy. So they just got really unlucky in the red zone from time to time. I think all that's going to clear up against a pretty bad Colts defense.
And I think Shaq Leonard is still like in the concussion protocol, possibly, as you know, their star middle linebacker. The biggest question, do we immediately get true wide receiver 1 usage? And when Trevor gets his choice based on the coverage, it seems like so far he is obviously always looking for Calvin Ridley. Something that I have been doing is taking your rankings and comparing them over to consensus rankings just to find the biggest dichotomy between the two. This is one of them. Consensus rankings of like 100 other fantasy football analysts have Calvin Ridley as wide receiver 15. That's a major hedge. That is, you know, trying not to live a little bit and stick your neck out there. And you are. I absolutely love this, Hayden.
Yeah, I know ball.
Well, we'll see. Maybe we figure out based on the biggest differences and gaps in consistent rankings each week, if that is you proving yourself. If YKB, Keenan Allen, and Mike Williams back-to-back as your wide receiver 12 and wide receiver 13. Why are these Chargers against the Miami Dolphins so high up in your rankings?
Well, just looking at it last year, the Chargers played a lot of pace, lots of pass rate. They were 3rd in yards. It was just the touchdowns that weren't going into the end zone. Right now, the Chargers are projected for the 2nd most points on the week at 27. It's a home game. The Dolphins have a chance to make this a shootout. But more importantly right now, the Dolphins' secondary is absolutely obliterated by injuries. Jalen Ramsey's on IR, Keon Crossan's on IR, Nick Needham's on the PUP list. Right now, it's like Xavien Howard, who actually led the NFL in yards allowed per PFF, and Eli Apple on the outside, who was 7th in most yards allowed last year. So that's why I have this massive Mike Williams ranking. And then for Keenan Allen, who might play in the slot a little bit more, their Dolphins nickel corner, he allowed the 8th most targets per snap last year. So like my question is like, why am I not ranking these two higher than this? Like, wow. The Chargers are projected for the second most points. We know they're going to pass the ball. We don't think that Quinton Johnson is going to have a role. Joshua Palmer is not a target getter. Gerald Everett is out there just in case something else happens. These are where the ball is going to. And we know there's going to be a lot of balls going into the end zone.
Yeah. I mean, I do think Quinton Johnson is going to have a role. I bet he plays around 30 to 40, maybe even 50% of the snaps. I do want to bring up that consensus rankings have Mike Williams as wide receiver 25. Do you think that's just from the perception that he is a all or nothing spiked week type player and not someone like you are ranking here who is locked into your lineup no matter what?
Well, the last 2 years, so like last year, Mike Williams was the wide receiver 21. And that was a very injury plagued year, and the Chargers offense just wasn't as good. The left tackle wasn't healthy. And then the year before that, he was the wide receiver 9. So I just don't understand the wide receiver 25 ranking.
Geno Smith is your quarterback 7 against the Los Angeles Rams defense. This is quite different than the consensus rankings out there who have him as the quarterback 11 this week.
So this is a good example of why I'm really big into using the Vegas implied team totals. Like you see the Seahawks right here. They're top 5 in projected points this week. It's a home game. Jaxon Smith-Njigba is supposed to play. He was actually a full participant on Wednesday, which was a surprise to me, but that's good news for Geno Smith. The Rams defense is a disaster, and I think we're going to keep riding that over and over again. And Geno Smith was a top 8 fantasy quarterback last year, and like this is a perfect matchup. Vegas agrees. So this is one of those where like I think the consensus rankings, when we refresh on Sunday, we'll start ranking Geno Smith closer to where I have him.
Yeah, if you're ever streaming quarterbacks or looking for a fill-in, like the easy equation of everything is if you're a home favorite and your team is expected to score 24 points. The Seahawks are home favorites, expect to score nearly 26 points this week. Just a quick anecdote about my fantasy teams. Often I drafted Deshaun Watson, and if I double upped at that position, because I feel a bit uneasy about it, it was with Geno Smith. I'm starting Geno Smith on those rosters, on those teams, over Deshaun Watson every single time this week.
I have one more note on the Rams defense. They lost the most cap dollars on defense this offseason. They traded away Jalen Ramsey, lost some other key pass rushers. That is an incredible stat. They are so inexperienced on every single level. We're just going to keep targeting them.
We'll keep it going with one of our favorite players. And this is hyper, hyper aggressive. But I get it with Luke Musgrave, because right now, Romeo Doubs and Christian Watson are being held out of practice.
Yeah, this is assuming that both of them are going to miss this game with a hamstring injury. If not, then I'll move Musgrave down. But really, Musgrave is going to be a full-time player regardless of those guys being in the lineup or not. It just means that he's probably going to see a couple more targets here. We saw him schemed up a little bit in the preseason in the training camp videos with Musgrave, and I think they might have to do that if they're going to be trotting out basically like UDFAs and seventh rounders
and
Jaden like and Jaden Reed. But like Jaden Reed's like might have to be playing on the outside some, and he's a smaller slot type of
they could guy. Run a ton of two tight end sets and have Luke Musgrave, which we talked about in 4 wide receiver sets, he was just going to be detached from the formation and play legit wide receiver stuff.
Yeah, so this is kind of like the same thing with Higbee because of injuries.
More explosive.
Yes, I think Musgrave is like significantly better than Tyler Higbee is. Chicago, of note though, they did upgrade their linebackers. They got a decent safety duo, so like the matchup individually for Musgrave is not that good, but really the matchup means less than just like the volume, because a lot of these guys that we'll talk about soon, like we don't even know if they're going to be on the field. I know Musgrave is.
Where do you think that consensus rankings have Luke Musgrave this week?
I'm at 18.
24.
Yeah.
Tight end 24. This is the perfect example of why you need to tune into our Sunday morning Q&A show, because let's say we get positive reports on Christian Watson and or Romeo Doubs, then this ranking is going to change, but it's not going to drop all the way down to tight end 24. We'll tell you that. Because we like Luke Musgrave because we know talent when we see it.